Hey friends, welcome to another video of Strength of Material. In this video, we will derive the relation between modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity. Let us consider a square block ABCD whose sides are of length A and thickness is unity. This square block is subjected to shear stress tau here. As shear stress on a single face cannot exist, there will be equal shear stress on the other face also, like this. And as a result of this shear force, the square block will deform to a shape, diamond-like shape, like this. A, B, C, D will be A dash, this, B dash. Now you see carefully that as a result of this deformation, the diagonal AC is increased to A dash C and the diagonal BD is reduced to B dash D. This means that along the diagonal AC, there is some tensile stress, and along diagonal BD, there is some compressive stress. And we have to calculate this tensile and compressive stress. Now to do this, let us cut the square block in two shapes, like this, and for the compressive stress, like this. See, this is the stress tau here, the resultant force will look like this. So the tensile stress here will be like this. We have to calculate this tensile stress. It is tau dash. Similarly, here the resultant force will be like this, and the compressive stress will be like this. Will be also tau dash. Now let us calculate the value of tau dash. This force here, stress into area. Area is the plane here is length A and thickness 1, so A into 1, and this component will be cos 45 degree, and that is 2 tau, so 2 into, it will be equal to the force here, which is tau dash into the area, the length is root 2A into thickness 1. Solve this, you get tau equal to tau dash. Now we got our tensile and compressive stress, both are equal to the shear stress applied. Now we have to calculate the strain along AC. The diagonal AC has got strain for both the tensile stress and the compressive stress. The diagonal AC has got a tensile strain for the stress, and there is some strain in AC for this compressive stress also, for the Poisson's effect. So let us write down the strain in AC equal to strain due to tensile stress, this one, plus strain due to compressive stress. The strain due to tensile stress is nothing but the tensile stress by the Young's modulus, and the strain due to compressive stress, you have to take into the Poisson's effect. It will be minus of Poisson's ratio into the strain. The strain due to the compressive stress is negative, so minus tau by E, tau by E into 1 plus mu. Now, let us try to find out the strain in AC from this diagram. Let us draw a perpendicular, say it is A double dash, and you see this AC and A double dash C are equal, and the change in AC is nothing but this A dash A double dash. Strain AC is equal to A dash A double dash by the original length of AC. Now you see this is 45 degree, and there is a very small change in length, so this angle will be also approximately equal to 45 degree. So you can write here A dash cos 45 degree, and this AC is the diagonal root 2A. You get A dash by A into 1 by 2. So A dash by A, you can write A equal to AD to 1 by 2. So A dash by AD is nothing but the shear strain phi. So you can write phi by 2. So you can now equate these two. So get tau by phi is equal to E by 2 into 1 plus mu. And this tau by phi, the shear stress by shear strain, is nothing but the shear modulus or modulus of rigidity G. E equals to 2G into 1 plus mu. Or mu is the Poisson's ratio. So this is the relation between the modulus of elasticity and the modulus of rigidity. Hope you like this video. Give a thumbs up, share with your friends, stay subscribed. See you in the next video.